We started great because plant breeding has a problem with gender. Everyone wants better crops and management strategies, yet all too often, women farmers don't benefit from new agricultural technologies. There aren't any simple solutions. In households across sub-Saharan Africa, people of all ages and gender identities use and benefit from crops differently. Dr. Margaret Mangani of Makerere University in Kampala, Uganda, and the co-founder of GREAT, argues that development activities aren't responding to these nuances, causing African women to be left behind.
This disconnect between the social sciences, gender, and agriculture is something that's prevalent almost all over. You see a gap because the people we graduate are not able to provide services in a manner that puts into consideration the needs of men and women, deliberately aiming at inclusive development that takes into consideration the socio-cultural context of the participants. Women play a key role in the farming systems, and therefore, if their voices are not heard, there is a high price with regard to attainment of development outcomes. So this is very key, especially in sub-Saharan Africa.
So-called gender blindness has consequences, making it more likely that women and other socially disadvantaged groups' needs go unnoticed. In the worst case scenario, the time, resources, and money spent on research may even negatively impact farmers and households. GREAT bridges the gap between gender, agriculture, and the social sciences. We provide researchers with the practical skills and tools they need to understand what farmers, value chain stakeholders, and consumers want in new crop varieties. Our training program is informed by a critical lens on gender and power dynamics within agricultural value chains.
After attending the GREAT course, my eyes were opened, my mind was enlightened. It sort of, they almost took off, you know, sort of like a cover from my eyes, because attending the GREAT course really allowed me to see why it is important for me as a breeder, as a researcher, as somebody who wants to impact the community in terms of agricultural development and crop improvement, how important it is for me to consider gender in designing my research projects and how I implement research projects and their objectives and their goals. So it was really sort of a life changing in terms of my career and how I view my career objectives.
I think that the training has enriched my understanding of the practice of gender inclusion. It is not merely having women and men participating. Absolutely everything that I was taught here brings in something new into my way of looking at a society, looking at crop management. As an entomologist, I'll be biased towards control the insects and the problem is solved, or bring in new material and the problem is solved. But now it's becoming more and more clear that I have to also withdraw from entomology, enter the household and imagine that I'm making decisions with them, and then try to respond back to my recommendations and see which ones of them work and which ones of them don't work.
The term empowerment is one of those terms that almost everybody uses, and everybody interprets it like different for different situations, different moments. And then we got this presentation that looked in a very methodological approach to the term empowerment. And everybody was like, wow, finally, I think I understand what this is about.
This course, first of all, starts with a piece on self-realization. Researchers understanding themselves as gendered beings and their gender identity and how society has shaped them and positioned them in very unique ways, and how this now influences the way they do their research, the kinds of research problems they choose to research on, and the methodologies that they choose to use.
The product that we can offer as GREAT is a focused training program tailored to the needs of your research. We can organize for you a training basically that will allow both your biophysical scientists, in this case the breeders, and the social scientists that you have there in your country, to come together, look at what they've been doing, and make sure we use the gender lens to assess as to whether you've actually been gender responsive. And the good thing is that each of your scientists will continue to be the scientists they're supposed to be, but they'll learn to work together to come up with a very good tailored package that allows your scientists to go through this gender responsive research planning and implementation process, but even allows you to publish work that can say has had a gender responsive process.
I came away from this training thinking, wow, you should always learn and be very, very open to learn. This is a beautiful thing going on. Work with the great trainers so that they understand your project, and then now they can contextualize the training to fit your needs. There is a lot of value because they have this unique combination of qualitative trainers, quantitative trainers, and even the analytical thinking is actually quite unique. Dealing with many teams over time, they've gained a competency around contextualizing gender issues that is quite unique. It's a lasting movement that we create in getting gender responsive capacity development for the region.